Hello guys, KP Shamino here with my second video about the Tidebreaker Berserker Marauder build. So I'm a little bit further in the game. I'm almost level 82. So I did already a couple of tier 10 maps. So I'm now getting to the end game. So I'm going to start tier 11 and above. Guardians I'm going to try too. Atzeri, Uber Labyrinth. So I'm just before I enter the end game, the very high end game. And now, most of the time, this breaks or make build good. So I'm not sure that I can do it with this build, but I'm going to test it out. Okay, so what did I change? So first of all, I went to Ice Crash. Why did I went to Ice Crash? Because it's now an Ice Crash build, and I'm going to keep an Ice Crash build because I cannot change a lot anymore in the tree. So why did I do it? Because they buffed Ice Crash, and in my opinion, I think at the moment it was a little bit better than Ground Slam. Ground Slam got one big problem: it does not have a lot of DPS, and that's a very big problem. And Ice Crash is like a nice cone; you can hit a lot of stuff. I think it goes a little bit faster, in my opinion. It works a little bit better. Therefore, I did it. So I needed to change a lot of stuff on the tree. Not a lot of stuff, but I needed to take elemental damage because that scales really good with Ice Crest. But I will show you guys that. So first of all, I got now a 5 link on my Tidebreaker. It's very expensive because if you check a 6 link on the Legacy League, you pay 10 Exalted. This one is one exalted, but I crafted myself, so I was very lucky. I had 5 sockets, I did like 10 fusings, and I had a 5 link. And it works really well because this is now a 6 link because the Tidebreaker, of course, gives a level 20 endurance charge on melee stun. For the guys that want to check, because I forgot it, want to check the tree, it's under this video, and I got a link to the website of Poto, so you guys can check it with buy online gear, because I'm not going to make a detailed guide. That's for the next video. That's probably the total guide, the next video. I'm sure of it. It's going to be the video. That's the build, guys. That's the end game build. You can do this and that with it. And then I go to the next build. So I'm still using this one, and I will go really quick over the links. I got elemental focus support, I got physical to lightning support, I got weapon elemental damage support, ice crash, and melee physical damage support. My tooltip DPS at the moment is 70k. That's not bad. That's when I only got 5 links. So it's 6 links, but endurance charge is not really DPS wise. So I think easily, if I can link something else on it, it's going to be 88,000-90,000 unbuffed without my totem, without my endurance charges up, because my endurance charge is buffing me too, without my frenzy charges up. So it's going to be 150,000-160,000, I think, at the end, if I got very good gear. I think even more. 200k is possible with this build. So yeah, and the gear, I got the Ghoul. For the guys that don't know, check my video. It's a very good hat that you can use. It gives level 1 shrines if you kill enemies, but it speeds up so fast the farming, and you need to farm a lot. I still use Carnage, but I think it's now time to start replacing it because I don't have HP on this item. And yeah, I want a little bit more HP because I'm now 5,300 HP. I want to get to 6k for sure. But the last notes that I'm going to take, I will show you guys that when we go to the passive tree skill, is going to be HP. Because my DPS is more than enough. I got 2 nodes DPS, and the other one are going to be just HP. I got 5 link too. This is my totem, so you guys will check. You can check it all the gemlings. I'm not going to go in detail. Not a lot of money. I got dish gloves too. Why? You got increased melee damage on it. For the flasks, of course, one that can remove a curse, one that can remove a bleeding. I got a granite flask, but I'm probably going to get the lion's what is it called? The lion's flask that gives like 33 physical reduction. So I'm going to replace that. I'm going to get Taste of Hate too, but it's too exalted. It's very expensive. Too exalted. Yeah, you need to farm a lot to get it, and you need to have a lot of luck too. But the build overall, I'm very happy with the build. It's getting really good, and it's possibility that with end build, I'm going to put a bleed effect on it too. Bleed effect, poison effect works really good. Yeah, most of the time you need to have it for the higher tier bosses. It Yeah, it's because we cannot scale a lot of DPS. You got DPS, here is your DPS, and that's it. You are using Resolute techniques. You cannot do a lot. You cannot go elemental overload because you don't crit. So it's a non-crit build, and it's always very difficult to go really easy on like end bosses without blood, without poison. So I already got my my Void Heart ring. So for the guys that don't know what that ring is. Let me have a look where I got it. Because the funny part is that this character is called Ground Slammy. Now it's an Ice Crash character. But yeah, there is not a lot I can do about it. Here is the ring. So Void Heart. So it just gives like an enemy a chance to bleed and an enemy a chance to poison. And if you put then on your totem Bloodlust. Let's have a look where it is. I think that I'm leveling it. Bloodlust on your totem. It's going to scale really cool. So you are going to do a lot of damage with the bleed. And you are going to do a lot of damage. So I'm just thinking. I think I'm going to put it in the build too for that extra DPS. Because like I said, a two-handed Marauder don't have a lot of scaling. Okay, that's it a little bit, guys. Straight on. It works really well, the build at the moment. The speed is not the fastest speed because there are builds that goes a lot faster. Today I was looking to a Spark build, and yeah, if you compare it with this is like my grandpa is like running against Usain Bolt, and I'm the grandpa. So, but yeah, it's like this. You cannot do a lot, grandpa, grandfather, sorry. So you cannot do a lot about it, but it's a fun build. You guys will see it because I'm going to show a little bit of gameplay too. Okay, so now the passive tree skill. So this was all the same, I think. So this is all the same too. I'm not sure that I'm going to go with Vaal Pact. I need to test that on the Guardians. I think that I cannot leech enough life without Vaal Pacts on very hard-hitting bosses. Because Atziri, if you get hit by the crap on the ground of with the spears that they throw, you need to get your life really back, yeah, to the maximum. Otherwise, you're dead. So I need to test that. If I need Vaal Pact on the Guardians, Shaper, Uber, Atziri, all that stuff, if I can do it, of course, and if I got the currency, and I need Vaal Pact, it's going to be in the end build, but at the moment I don't know it. I worked my way to here, so for 4 or 5 points, I can go easily to Vaal Pact, but I will test it in the end build. So that's just the same, I think, than before. I got now 6 Endurance charges too, and that's going to be the maximum, because I'm not going to this one. I lose too much points. Because I need HP and a little bit more DPS. This area I changed. Why? Because I'm now using Ice Crest. So I took elemental damage here. Elementalist. I took that too. Just to buff the Ice Crest. And that works really well. So, yep. That's it, guys. So that's the build. And now it's time. I'm going to show you guys some gameplay. So, for the guys that were following the guide, I didn't change that much. Because. The areas that I was moving, I just use the skills that are around that area. Okay, so let's have a look that we can get a map here. Let's go to my map. Let's do a peer map. I'm not going to do ridiculous stuff with those maps because I'm still leveling and I don't have undead. Players have 40 less recovery rate of life and energy. Yeah, that's okay. It's only tier 8. So let's do a tier 8 map just to show you guys how fast Endurance charges go up, the Frenzy charges. So for the Frenzy charges, the main problem is that I'm using Blood Rage. But I don't like Blood Rage a lot because you need to kill enemies to get the Frenzy. So that's the main problem. I think that I'm going to use the Jewel. For the guys that don't know, there is a Jewel. That gives you a chance to get a frenzy, and that's a lot easier. I think it's dropping somewhere on a breach boss. I'm not sure because I'm not really a specialist in breach because I didn't play leagues. That's my first league that I play in Path of Exile. I was always on standard. So, but we will see. I think that I'm going to use that because I can, if I'm not mistaken, use a frenzy on a single target. And that's very handy because frenzies they buff the DPS very high. So let's have a look how it works, guys. Okay, here we go. Ah, by the way, guys, before I forgot, this is optional. So elemental proliferation, it works really well with Herald of Ash. So you guys will see it, but if you don't have the DPS, it's not going to work that good because you are going to lose, it jumps. So Herald of Ash, the damage that you do more than the HP is divided around the area, and this is going to make the area bigger. So now we're changing the AoE, the increased AoE. This is really good, but you need to have the DPS, otherwise you are not killing those dudes. You will see, I got now the DPS, they are melting. But it's optional. If you don't want to use it, you don't use it. At the start, I didn't use it because my DPS was not high enough. And my, what is it called? Is it overload damage? I'm not sure. Overkill damage was not high enough. So it's a little bit waste. But once you get at the level 60k unbuffed, you can use it. You guys will see it, what I mean with it. Okay, let's do some action. And I already got here a gem that is. So what I do is you jump and check. The range that I got, check, it's all melting, and that's what I like, is very cool. So that's how easy it, and that's the proliferation that is doing that, because if you use only Herald of Ash, it's not going that far, it's jumping. Check, those dudes are burning and they are melting, so therefore you need to have enough DPS. So it works really well, the build. So I got now my 6 endurance charges, I got my 3 frenzies. So let's get the totem up, DPS check, 129,000 DPS. And that's not bad because I'm only level 81. And yeah, it works really good. I'm very happy with the endurance charges. So it goes really quick. And that's what I like. A lot of people are talking about this mace, about the stun. But that's not important on this mace. The endurance charges are important. Okay, it has to do with each other because you need to stun to get the endurance charges. But the endurance charges are the most important for a berserker. Why? Because we cannot generate them. A juggernaut can do that when he gets hit, but we cannot do it. So a lot of DPS. I forgot one thing before I end the video. My ascendancy point, Aspect of Carnage, but I think I already said that in the first video. And I'm going, of course, to cloaked in Savagery, because yeah, I think that's a very good, how do you say it, ascendancy point. I think it's OP, to be honest. But of course, you need to get the hit. On that moment, it's like not even a second and you're totally full. You got a lot of DPS too. You can just burn stuff. So that was it for the build, guys. I cannot say more. So it works really well at the moment. The range is really cool. Here you go. And most important, I like to play this build, and that's really cool too. So that was it for the video, guys. Thanks for watching. Have fun with the build if you play it. The next video is going to be the end build, but I'm not sure when I'm going to upload it. I hope in less than a week, because now the work starts and I need currency for it. Atziri, Uber Atziri, Shaper, the Guardians. It's all the hard currency that I need to buy those maps or to farm those maps. But at the moment, the build works really well. I hope it helps you guys. Thanks for watching and have fun in Path of Exile. Bye bye.